What Remains of Edith Finch is a game that was released in 2017 and it was developed by Giant Sparrow. When I first played What Remains of Edith Finch a few years ago, I quite didn't get it. I was like, what kind of game is this? And I was expecting something else. But I guess it wasn't until recently that I decided to purchase it for myself and to actually play it for myself, because I've heard great things about it, that I finally understood the beauty of this game. Let alone how beautiful it looks, you know, by itself. The animations, the art, how the text is displayed on screen and then it moves with certain objects in the game, how it makes you interact with objects in a very fun and unique way, and how Giant Sparrow are great when it comes to storytelling. Now, the story of What Remains of Edith Finch is about a mother, Edith, going back to her family house in Orcas Island in Washington. Now, this island is very particular and the house is very particular, but so is the family. So that's all. That's all when it comes to the story. You go to the house and you explore it and you discover the story of the Finch family. But I think it's a very, very unique story that everyone who appreciates single player games, narrative games, storytelling games should play. Seriously, if you haven't played it, go ahead and play it. I seriously can't recommend it enough. It's on discount right now on the summer sale on Steam, and there's nothing else I can say about the game. I think it's one of the best games I've ever played. Now, I wanted to give you my personal take on the game. Now, I'm going to put a spoiler warning here, and I do encourage you to play it by yourself. I can't recommend it enough, and it's a short game. It's 3 hours long, tops. Maybe four if you kind of stop and look at absolutely everything, but like I said, go play it by yourself if you really care about the game, and I think you should. Now, people can interpret games and film in many, many ways, but to me, What Remains of Edith Finch is a game about not being able to let go, about nostalgia and how hard it can be to deal with. And with nostalgia comes sadness and fear.
Be delicious. I'm not sure if I believed all of that, but I'm sure Edie would have.
To me, this story is not really about Edith Jr., our protagonist. It is more about Edith Sr., her grandma, and how she couldn't deal with the reality of life, with the reality of how things really are. So she made one for herself and for her family. And after all, it is easier to do that rather than to actually face reality. There are actually two problems with this. One is that she shouldn't have included her family. She could have created this reality for herself, but she shouldn't have done it for her family. And the other problem is not knowing where the limit is. If you don't know where the limit is, then there is a problem. And if you play the game, you know what I'm talking about, and you know the story of King Louis. And I guess a lot of us are guilty for this, because we immerse ourselves in video games rather than to facing reality. I know not everyone is like this, and at the end of the day, we have to face reality no matter what. No matter how much we want to distance ourselves from real life or distract ourselves, we have to face reality at the end of the day. The game is about a family tradition. According to Edith, there's this family tradition or this family curse where the Finches are cursed because they all have died in very fantastic and quote-unquote unique ways, in very particular ways. Most of them are coincidences, and most of these are portrayed in very fantastical ways, in very fantasy and fairy tale-like ways. Even Edith is obsessed with this. She drew on the doors. She put peepholes, and in all of the rooms you can find like shrines or a little museum for all of her kids, for all of the Finches. And there comes a point where this tale becomes an obsession. For example, how she told her granddaughter that her husband was killed by a dragon when in reality he was killed building a slide, or how there was a mole man living under the house when in reality was her neglected son. There's a point, there's a limit, and Edith couldn't see it. She was so trapped in her reality that she couldn't see how things really were. Now, leaving Edith Senior on the side for a bit and focusing just a tiny bit on Edith Junior, actually our playable character, not only she continued the family tradition of not being able to let go, but it also passed the tradition to her son. And who knows if he'll be able to give it up. It's not normal to immortalize your family like this, or block and seal doors just to make peepholes in the doors, then give interviews about a mole man living under the house when in fact it is your son, or allowing a silly comic to be made about your daughter's death just to keep this stupid tradition or family curse alive. It's an obsession, it's an unhealthy obsession. And if you think about it, what is Edith Jr. doing crawling in her old family house while she's pregnant? The house is not exactly safe for a pregnant woman, and yet she's still there because she's so obsessed with the past, she's so nostalgic about it, and she can't let go. I know she received the key, but she could have just let go. She could have just let go, but because her mother tried to protect her by not telling the stories to her, she fell for the family tradition of not being able to let go. So she came back, because she had to find the story for herself. And letting go is not bad, but it is hard. And like I said, you have to know a point where you have to learn to let go.
If there's a pattern in all these stories, I think it's that none of us has gotten very far.
Now, on a more personal side, I can't really relate to this story. And I don't mean it literally. I know a lot of us don't have this humongous and beautiful house. I mean in a way that I have never been attached to my family, to anyone in my family other than my mom. In fact, I think that's what makes me emotional about this game. While I do believe most of the deaths are emotional and very, very sad, and overall this game is very dark and depressing, but told in a very unique way so it doesn't seem so dark, but it is actually dark, because in a way, if you think about it, we're stepping into Edith's world, so all of the deaths are told to us like tales, like fairy tales, like stories, not 100% like they really happened, but we are, as the players, are forced to piece them ourselves. We are forced to look through this peephole that is the real world. So like I said, while I do believe most of the deaths are very emotional, I think that's linked to the storytelling of the game. But back to what I was saying, that I'm not really attached to my family other than to my mom. Part of the game that made me emotional was at the end where Edith Jr. is revealed to have died in childbirth. And I found that very, very sad. So who we play as the beginning of the game, and ultimately, if you think about it, throughout the game, is her son kind of reliving her story, kind of reading this diary that she left for him. What makes me emotional is the death of Edith at the end, leaving this beautiful journal to her son. And I imagine my mom doing something similar for me. So that's what hits me personally. And I can't believe what this experience must be like for someone who's attached to their family, or for a mother, or even a father. I imagine the story of the baby must have been very, very hard to process for a father or for a mother. And like I said, all of these coincidental deaths ultimately are linked not by coincidence, but for personal problems like neglect and regret, and also for not wanting to face the truth, own up to your mistakes, and being able to let go. Edith couldn't face that she neglected her child and left her to die in her room. While it was a coincidence, it was ultimately because of her punishment. Who sends her child to bed without eating, without having dinner? And who places poisonous berries in her bathroom? Who can be so irresponsible? And if you think about it, what's easier? Face the truth that you've been an irresponsible mother, or set this reality for yourself that, oh, your family has a curse. It's a family tradition to die in fantastical ways. And also that's why Dawn, Edith's junior mother, stands out. That's why she was the quote-unquote black sheep, because she saw the big picture. Just like Edith was able to look through the peepholes and go into this fantasy world, Dawn was able to see the truth via this fictional peephole. Both were looking just through different worlds. And that's why she didn't want to tell Edith. That's why she didn't want Edith to fall for this family tradition or curse situation. She just wanted Edith to move on. But she couldn't, because nostalgia is very hard to deal with. And with nostalgia comes fear. And with nostalgia comes sadness. And one can only hope that Edith's kid will be able to move on from this family curse or family tradition, because we as people have to learn to let go. Thank you so much for watching, and remember that this was simply my opinion. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you played the game, let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Take care of yourself.
Stories for myself, and found out what happened to everyone else. But now I'm worried the stories themselves might be the problem. Maybe we believed so much in a family curse, we made it real.